Yeah. time. 是永远在我们身旁的君王，你是好神。 You are a good God。 哈利路亚，哈利路亚，呜，赞美你，赞美你，赞美你，赞美你，哈利路亚。弟兄姐妹，我们今天是有一个非常特别的一个敬拜，就是一个宣告式的敬拜。今天我们要宣告我们的环境，我们任何我们所面对的现在，我们要跟大家说，神与我们同在，你不会打败我们的。 Amen。 大军站起来敬拜他。
Tell us who we are when there's no faith in us. Where can I put my trust when there seems to be no hope? There is only one God who is always by my side. By his words he restores me and leads me all the way and says,
what he says. So come
兄姐妹，我们可以就这样子像一个大军一样站起来。哈利路亚，我们一起来宣告，神是我们的神，我们还有谁呢？还惧怕谁呢？哈利路亚， Yes， 来拍手，用我们的脚来踏践踏仇敌在我们的脚下， Defeat our enemy under our feet。告诉你的问题， hey, hey, 告诉你的问题， hey, 我是得胜的。
Yeah. 主，我们知道，主啊，你的国度要在我们当中。
Lord, we know that you want to manifest your kingdom in our midst.
弟兄姐妹，当国神的国在我们当中的时候
，Brothers and sisters, as the kingdom of God comes,
它是会有一个转化。
There will be a transformational shift.
它是有能力的注入。
There is power that will come in.
所以我们要相信，当神的国在我们当中的时候，很多事情就会有改变。
So we need to believe that many things will change when the kingdom of God comes.
所以我请我们今天早上，我请我们的服事团队来为弟兄姐妹来祷告。
I would like to invite our power ministry team to come to the front to pray for our brothers and sisters.
我们可以请坐。
Please be seated.
第一群的弟兄姐妹，我们想服事你的。
The first altar call for brothers and
sisters. 是你在这段日子里面。
Is that in this period of time?
有很多的焦虑在你的里面。
You have a lot of anxiety.
有一个莫名的恐惧会临到你。
There's unexplained fear in you.
很多时候在夜深人静的时候，你不能够入睡，你很焦虑。
A lot of times you have insomnia in the dark night.
这样的弟兄姐妹，等一下你可以来到我们台前。
Brothers and sisters like this, you may come to the front.
第二
，Secondly,
我想为一些弟兄姐妹来祷告。
I want to pray for certain brothers and sisters.
在当中，神要帮助我们，凡是在疾病上面有需要的。
God wants to help those who are in sicknesses.
第二
，Secondly,
在关系上面有需要的。
In relationship, if you have this need.
第三
，And thirdly,
在你的经济上面你有需要的。
You have need in your finance.
我要请我们的服事团队来为你们这些的事情来发预言。
I would like to invite our power ministry team to prophesy for you in these issues.
我深深感到神的灵在这里的时候，有很大的突破的能力要在当中。
I sense that when there is great power of God in our midst, there shall be great breakthroughs.
所以刚才弟兄姐妹，如果我有讲到你的
brothers and sisters, if what I said of,
我可以欢迎你现在来到台前。
Is related to you, may I welcome you to the stage?
赶紧来到台前。
And come quickly.
这个时候是圣灵工作的时候。
This is the time for the work of the Holy Spirit.
圣灵的介入。
The intervention of the Holy Spirit.
圣灵气息要进入到我们生命里面。
The breath of the Holy Spirit shall come into our lives.
我们需要更多的同工。
We need more co-workers.
我们请我们的同工。
I would like to invite our co-workers.
在线上的弟兄姐妹。
Brothers and sisters online.
你可能来不到我们的现场。
Perhaps you can't join us on site.
但是我奉耶稣基督的名字。
But in Jesus' name I declare.
同样的圣灵的大能要去到你们那里。
Similarly, the power of Holy Spirit shall come upon you.
一个突破的能力。
The power.
现在无论你在哪里
irrespective of where you are,
你向神来呼求
you cry out to God now,
奉耶稣基督的名字
in Jesus name,
现在圣灵要去到你
now Holy Spirit shall come to you,
我们需要一些的组长
we need more sound leaders,
我们需要我们的组长
sound leaders,
也可以前来我们为我们这些有需要的弟兄姐妹来祷告
please come to the front to pray for those who are in need,
我们还需要一些的组长
we need more sound leaders,
在座的弟兄姐妹
brothers and sisters who are seated,
可能你说
perhaps you say,
这一些我都没有问题
I do not have these issues,
但是我盼望你坐在你的位置上面
but I hope that as you are seated at your
更多来渴慕
desire more,
你向神来祷告
pray to the Lord,
神啊我需要你
and say that Lord I need you,
神啊愿你的圣灵更大来触摸我
may your Holy Spirit touch me greatly,
谢谢你
thank you,
主啊帮助我们
dear Lord help us,
释放我们
Release us.
现在
right now.
奉耶稣基督的名字
in Jesus' name.
所有的焦虑要离开我们
all the anxiety shall leave us now.
斥责所有的恐惧
I rebuke all the fear.
所有的惧怕
all the fear.
因为惧怕不是从神来
because fear does not come from the Lord.
所有的 anxiety.
All the anxiety.
Depression.
Depression.
奉耶稣基督的名字
in Jesus' name.
我要斥责你离开
I rebuke you.
如果还没有人为你祷告，你举一举手，让我们同工看得到你。
If you have yet to be prayed upon,
我们那里还需要有一同工弟兄。
We need another brother co-worker.
所以我们来到你的面前，把所有弟兄姐妹交在你手中。
Lord, we come before you and submit all brothers and sisters into your hand.
求你圣灵的大能现在当中。
May your power of Holy Spirit
可以自由的来运行。
To work freely.
我们还有需要的。
We have someone in need here.
我们可以来到前面。
Please come to the front.
来，我们服事的时间很紧凑。
We have very limited time.
如果你有需要的，你赶紧来到前面。
Please quickly come to the front if you have need.
我们这里还有位可以服事的。
We have one more person that can minister to you here.
谢谢你主。
Thank you, Lord.
我们这里还可以有一位可以来这里服事的。
Another one can receive prayer here.
谢谢耶稣。
Thank you, Jesus.
主啊，你帮助我们。
Help us, Lord.
能力进入我们里面。
Power enter into us.
现在。
Right now.
无论我们状况如何。
Irregardless of our
circumstances. 主，你说你要给我们的力量也如何。
You say the power that you want to give us.
主，你帮助我们。
You help us.
现在。
Right now.
现在。
Right now.
现在。
Right now.
复活的气息。
The power of resurrection.
复活的盼望。
The power of hope.
注入到我们生命的里面。
Enter into our lives.
现在。
Right now.
释放我们。
Release us.
释放我们。
Release us.
我奉耶稣基督的名字。
In Jesus' name.
斥责那偷窃的。
I rebuke the thief.
那偷窃的。
The one that steals.
奉耶稣名字。
In Jesus' name.
我要斥责他离开。
I rebuke you now.
我要奉耶稣名字。
In Jesus' name.
捆绑仇敌的周围。
I bind all the works of the enemy.
捆绑恶者仇敌的周围。
I bind all the works of the enemy.
我要宣告。
I declare.
所有这些行为。
All of these works.
要被败坏。
Shall destroy.
要被败坏。
Shall destroy.
谢谢耶稣。
In Jesus' name, thank you.
谢谢耶稣。
Thank you, Jesus.
主啊，谢谢你。
Thank you, Lord.
谢谢你。
Thank you.
谢谢你。
Thank you.
谢谢你。
Thank you.
奉耶稣基督的名，我们要宣告。
In Jesus' name, we declare.
主，你的国降临。
Your kingdom comes.
你的旨意就在这里。
Your will be done here.
主，我要宣告，我们在你里面是大有盼望。
I declare that we have great hope in you.
主，你说你是赐福的神，不是咒诅的神。
God, you say that you are the one that bless and not the one that curse.
主，我要宣告。
I declare, Lord.
凡今天我们渴慕你的。
Those who are desire of you today.
主啊，你让我们大大的经历你。
You let us encounter you.
主，我更要宣告。
I declare.
仇敌所掳掠的。
The one that has been taken captive by the enemy.
仇敌所杀害的。
The one that has been killed by the enemy.
甚至仇敌所偷窃的。
The one that has been stolen by the enemy.
奉耶稣之名字。
In Jesus' name.
要完全的归回。
Shall be returned and restored completely.
完全的归回我们弟兄姐妹。
Be returned completely.
主，我们谢谢你。
We give thanks to you, Lord.
主，我们相信你的作为就在我们当中。
We believe your works in our midst.
我们宣告我们是得胜再得胜的。
We declare that we have victory upon victory.
这样的祷告宣告是奉耶稣基督的名。
Such prayer and declaration are done in the name of Jesus.
我们一起说。
Together we say.
Amen. 好不好？将掌声归给我们神。
We give all the glory and thanks to the Lord.
Amen. 我们的神是好神。
Our God is a good God.
他就在我们的当中。
He's among us.
所以我们用热烈的掌声来欢迎我们的神。
So we roll for this welcome, God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
我们也要欢迎今天第一次来到我们当中的新朋友。
We also want to welcome all our new friends who are being with us for the first time.
如果你是第一次来到，好不好？欢迎你站起来，我们要来用最热烈的欢迎来欢迎你。
So if this is your first time being with us, we'd like to invite you to stand up. We want to use our greatest, warmest welcome to welcome you.
啊，在我的右边有三位。
So on my right, there's three.
还有我的左边也有新朋友。
Then on my left, there's also new friends.
好不好？主的弟兄姐妹，我们一起站立。
So brothers and sisters of GLS, let's all rise up together.
我们彼此欢迎。
Let's welcome each other.
让神的爱充满在这里。
Let the love of God fill this place.
崇拜的弟兄姐妹和新朋友，也是欢迎你们。
And we also welcome our brothers and sisters and our new friends who are online with us. Welcome.
GA 一次欢迎。
GA once welcome.
永远欢迎。
Forever welcome.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
好，我们现在一起来预备心来奉献。
So let's now all prepare our heart for offering.
在圣经里面呢，耶稣有说到。
So in the Bible, Jesus once mentioned.
他看见有财主奉献。
So he saw the rich who actually offered.
同时他也看见有一个寡妇来到神的殿中来奉献。
But he also saw one poor widow come into the temple of God to offer.
然后耶稣就跟他的门徒说。
And then Jesus told his disciples.
这个寡妇奉献两个小钱比众人还要多。
So this poor widow who offered up these two mites is actually more than any others.
关键不是在于多或者是少。
So the key point is not on the figures, more or less.
关键是在于信心。
But the key is by us on the faith.
因为呢，这个寡妇所奉献的两个小钱是她养生的。
For this poor widow, the two mites that she offered up, it's actually all that she has.
当她把这一个奉献放在神的家的时候呢
？When she put this offering in the house of God,
其实她是充满信心的。
In fact, she was full of faith.
因为呢，她相信耶和华神所说的。
For she believed whatever Jehovah God had mentioned. mentioned.
万军之耶和华如此说。
The Lord of hosts, Jehovah, have once mentioned.
以此试试我。
Try me now on this.
是否为你敞开天上的窗户。
If I will not open for you the window of heaven.
倾覆于你们。
And pour out for you.
甚至无处可容。
Such blessing there will be no room enough to receive it.
所以弟兄姐妹。
So brothers and sisters.
同样的，今天我们来到神的面前。
Similarly, today as we come before the Lord.
当我们献上我们奉献的时候。
As we offer up our offerings.
让我们带着信心。
So with by faith.
因为信心的奉献。
For the offering by faith.
会让耶稣注意到的。
Will actually let Jesus take notice of it.
那我们可以用两种方式来奉献。
So we may offer up with two ways.
我们可以线上转账。
We can do our bank transfer online.
就是转可以把你的十一奉献呢，或者是你的感恩奉献呢，宣教奉献放在我们的 account 在你的左手边。
So you can put the tithes offering, thanksgiving offering, or missionary offerings to the bank account that's on your left.
Yeah.右手边呢就是给建殿的奉献
and on your right will be for the church building
或者如果你有带现金来的然后散会过后呢你可以把你的奉献放在奉献栏
and if you have brought cash then after the service you may put your offerings into the offering basket
让我们一起来祷告
so let's pray together
天父爸爸我们谢谢你
the Heavenly Father we thank you
真的天父爸爸你看重的是我们奉献的心
truly God what you look important in is our heart of offering
当我们甘心乐意带着信心来奉献
When we offer up willingly by faith
神你非常的喜悦
Lord you are more than happy
而且你说你会为我们打开天上的窗户
And Lord you say that you will open up the windows of heaven for us
倾覆于我们
And outpour your blessing upon us
甚至无处可容
That there will be no room enough to receive it
神你这样子说
Lord you have mentioned like this
我们就这样子的来相信
And we believe in your words
祝福我们弟兄姐妹
Bless every of our brothers and sisters
奉耶稣的名祷
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. 感谢神。
Amen. Praise the Lord.
神一定会祝福我们每个人。
God will surely bless every one of us.
如果你相信，你就把荣耀掌声归给神。
So if you believe, let's give all the glory to our God.
感谢神。
Praise the Lord.
接下来我们有两项的家事报告跟弟兄姐妹沟通。
Continue on, we will have two announcements for all brothers and sisters.
第一项呢就是普尔节特别崇拜
The first one will be Purim Special Service
这个日期呢就是在3月23跟24号也就是星期六跟星期天的三堂崇拜
So the dates will be on the 23rd and 24th of March That is on the Saturday and Sunday The three services
这次的主题是国的一半也必赐给你
So the team this time round will be up to half of the kingdom shall be given to you. So do you believe in this?
这是一个翻转的时刻。
So this is a time for transformation.
相信的话，再把荣耀掌声归给神。
So if believe it, once again, let's give all the glory and round applause to God.
第二项的报告呢，就是家有喜事。
The second announcement, there's something good happening in our family.
就是我们薛俊峰弟兄和邱恩佳姐妹将于3月16号星期六早上10点在祷告帐幕举行婚礼
That is our brother Edmund and sister Andra will be having their wedding in Tabernacle 16th of March Saturday 10 a.m.
我们在祷告中来纪念这一对新人也祝福这一对的新人
So we may remember and also bless them in our prayer
接下来呢我们就要去听一个见证
So continue on we'll listen to your testimony
还有主任牧师的话
Then we have the word of the city pastor
我们把时间交给媒体我们掌声欢迎
Let's pass our time to our media Let's give them a round of applause
Good morning brothers and sisters My name is Joshua Disciple of Pastor Moses I am honored to once again be the game master For last year's GA Star Kids Camp The campsite chosen for this survival camp was a beautiful small retreat compound. However, it did not provide us with any materials that we can use. All preparation had to be done on our side. There was over 8 hours allocated to game sections during this camp, more than any previous camp. The pressure was on to design multiple outdoor team building games and challenges, to take into account the weather, limited space, and limited teachers and helpers.In the end, we created 20 different games and challenges to be played. Some were our main games, meant to be played outdoors, and others were backups in case of rain and weather. This arrangement meant that there was no set plan for which games were going to be played next. The teachers and helpers had to adapt on the day and follow my instructions. This was a major consideration for me, as most of the helpers in this camp did not have much prior camp experience. In addition, I had also not worked closely with a lot of these helpers before, and was unsure on how they may respond to my leadership style. However, beyond my expectation, all the teachers and helpers went above and beyond, helping where they could, shifting between multiple roles, from the games team, to the food team, to the cleaning team, and to the teaching team. They were all willing to put the children first. No matter how tired they were, they still gave their best. I also got the chance to work closely with some of these helpers and get to know them better. Many of the teachers and helpers took leave from work, making special arrangements to spend more time with the children. I'm reminded once again that it is not the performance that makes a good team, but their willingness that allows them to overcome obstacles. Initially, our camp did not have the Tree of Life concept, but instead focused more on the physical survival aspect. However, due to the church's shift, we obeyed and shifted our camp to be more aligned with the church's vision. It was quite difficult incorporating the Tree of Life aspect into our games. I would often ask myself, how would the children be able to understand such a deep concept in the short amount of time, let alone use these learnings in games time when they are only focused on winning? However, God gave me wisdom. He gave me an idea to let the children choose between the Tree of Life and the Tree of Knowledge and Good and Evil. We created multiple power cards that the children could use to help or hinder other teams. Cards were split into three categories: the Tree of Life, Neutral, and the Tree of Knowledge and Good and Evil. We did not inform the children about these categories, but instead wanted to see which cards the children would choose when given a choice. To my surprise, the majority of the cards played were the ones from the Tree of Life category. When the Tree of Life card is played, other teams would also benefit. I recall this scene where a child played a card that allowed their team to gain 400 points, but as a result, had to share half of the points with another team. Nevertheless, the child chose to share her points with her sister's team. Both her and her sister's team were in similar number of points at the time, so giving away points meant that giving her competition a huge advantage as well. Even though her sister was on the enemy team, it did not matter to her. To her, they were still sisters, and she wanted to show her kindness and grace. I'm traditionally a very competitive person. When I play games or in life in general, I always strive to win. Not for the prize, but for the sense of success. I'm reminded of previous camps where I would use all my strength and tricks to win, sometimes hurting other people's feelings in the process. I would disregard their feelings, as in my mind, using all of my strength to beat them was my way of giving them respect as an equal. However, through the acts of this child, God has reminded me that the Tree of Life and showing kindness to those you love does not stop because you are at camp, or playing games, or trying to win. The true essence of camp is to build better relationship with others. Throughout the camp, the children got to gain points from winning games and performing acts of kindness to others. Similarly, points were also taken away for rule breaking and bad behavior. Before the final breakfast, we showed the kids how many points each team had. At this point, there were two teams leading, Zebulun and Issachar, with Zebulun leading with only 50 points. The children believed that the camp had ended and the winner had been decided. However, we still had breakfast and Thanksgiving sessions after this. The children did not know that points would also be given out during these last two sessions. After breakfast, the children were instructed to clean up the rooms and bring their luggage back to the main hall. Many children from Team Issachar helped the teachers and children fold blankets, helping with luggage and setting up the chairs in the main hall. They did all of these acts of kindness without hoping for additional points. To their surprise, it was because of these final acts of kindness that allowed Team Issachar to beat out Zebulun in the last seconds, claiming overall victory. I was very happy to see that the children start to pick up these good habits. Without the hope for reward, they automatically went to help. These children truly embodied the tree of life. Not only through helping the teachers, but also teaching those younger than them to help as well. God rewards those who are humble and work in a manner that aligns with God. This is the first camp after MCO that we held outside of church. And for most of the children, it was also their first camp as well. They were all too young to have joined camps before MCO. A lot could have gone wrong. Inexperienced campers, new teachers, all could have resulted in many mix-ups and errors. But God is good. In every step of the way, God guided us to run a successful and most importantly, safe camp. I am pleased to see that a lot of the children have grown. Through this experience, I have also grown. All glory to God.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹，我们最近在讲以西结书三十七章就是从第一节讲到第十节嘛，也就是我们GA610娘堂的意象篇。所以我们在讲身份的转变哦，因为我们是不单只讲以西结，其实我们要像以西结一样。可是很多人就问我，牧师要成为以西结很难啊，那个身份的改变特别有一些不是先知嘛。其实我们也要从另一个角度看，你可能不像以西结，可是你一定要学习有以西结的眼光和以西结的心思，因为真的在环境里面很多情况真的很需要用这个信心来看的。所以我想这个要应用在生活里面，我就想听一听我们在先知团队的两位先知他们怎样经历听了这一个意象篇，然后重新被眺望起来。所以你们怎么样应用在你们的生活里边？好，我们先请小慧来。
对，牧师一说我们是以西结的时候眼光就不一样了，所以心里面就会认为我是以西结，所以我要跟神是同意的，我要遵命然后发预言，然后很快的就有经历咯。就是第一次的经历哦，就是我妈妈的小狗不见了，两天过后呢她才打电话给我跟我说小狗不见了。所以跟她结束通话之后我就心想我很不甘心耶，因为这是我们家的东西，怎么可以让仇敌就这样子被就偷走这个东西，我很不甘心。所以后来我就奉耶稣的名字，我说我命令天使天君要去把这只小狗带回来。这只小狗才一个多月大，所以它基本上它不会回家的，所以我就说天使要去带它回来，只是做这样的一个简单祷告。那时候我跟我妈妈通话是晚上，第二天早上我妈醒来的时候就听到，哎，为什么有小狗叫声，她还以为是因为自己太想念那只小狗，结果出去门口一看小狗在门口。两天哦她就回来了，这是第一次的经历。哇，整个人很开心耶，这祷告很快就蒙应允了。然后呢第二次经历很快的就到第二次的经历就是上个星期六我们有一个聚餐，然后就听到一些人分享说他们为马来西亚的天气祷告。所以我们虽然现在在旱灾，但是还是有雨水嘛，所以那一天聚餐之后呢傍晚的时候皮就开始下雨，所以我看着这个一片白茫茫的雨水的时候，我就顾念到我的家，我就心想我也想要这些的雨水哦去滋润一下我家的土地。所以
你的家是在
彭亨州。
彭亨州，
对。所以当时就有一个感动，向着天发预言，我就看着白茫茫的天，我就举手，我奉耶稣的名字，我命令这些雨水要去到我家的土地上。然后第二天就是礼拜天晚上我打电话给妈妈的时候，就听到有雨水声，我就很紧张，我就问妈妈，我说妈妈是不是下雨，她讲是啊，下了一整天，已经很久没有下了，但是今天就是从早下到晚上。哇，我真的觉得那个的力量啊，心里面有那一个感动，这是神的命，所以我遵这个命，然后我 发愿，之后我什么都不想，我知道神会成就，或者神不成就，那有神的心意，我放开给神，结果事情就发生。
哇、wow, ，
对，
所以这个是身份提升，眼光
不一样，
超越，
对，
所以不一样的时候，你的所发的祷告，你发的命令，
对，
就看到果效，
对，
很感恩啊，这个应该对你来说是很吉利的一件事，
对，非常吉利，而且很真实。嗯
Amen、嗯、是啊，好啊，听听陆真回去台湾过年听了这个信息回去、嗯、感觉如何？
哦，牧师，我觉得真的是很被激励，因为我这次回台湾特别有感触，是因为回到台湾看到很多地方庙变得更大啦、嗯、偶像更多啊，哇，我就看到我相信台湾的教会可能在一个的困境里面，对，那这么刚好我们又去探访了几个朋友，那其中有一个朋友他的孩子就突然之间他就是去他亲戚家的时候，然后没有多久就一下就收到电话，就是说他有点昏厥的样子，然后就一直呕，然后后来就赶快紧急送去医院，就没有想到医院检查出来，哇，我很难过，是因为第一个他是传道人，第二个他是
很年轻，
对，比我还年轻哦，我觉得大有可为哦。对，那很难过，是很着急，是因为他很年轻，却医生检查出他有肾衰竭。对，我们知道肾衰竭一下去哦，整个器官都会被拖垮的，那他又加上是他有的那个尿毒素很高，是超标，所以其实是很危急的，所以他在医院送去医院之后，其实是他在 ICU， 而且是在一个昏迷的状况。对，所以当我得知这个状况的时候，哇，我就想着，嗯，因为那一天事情发生是在晚上，
是，
我就很想说，哎，隔天我可以去 ICU 探他一下，祷告一下，我觉得也好，我都很想要尽一份心力这样子。对，然后没有想到，哇，因为他真的太危急了，所以可以探他的时间非常短，我们又错失了哦，哇，错失了之后，我又问神。就这样子吗？你让我知道这件事情，我只能够这样子看着他这样子。但是后来不断的跟神祷告的时候，神依旧是跟我讲，没关系，你就去陪他家人，跟他家人一起祷告。对，然后我心里面也相信说，当我在祷告的时候，虽然是跟他家人祷告，但是可以透过他们的关系，这个祷告的能力也可以去到他身上。对，所以最后我就凭信心祷告咯，对，就是像以西结这样，因为是神告诉我就是去祷告，我就凭信心去顺服遵命去说去祷告。没有想到那天我们大概是早上9点多、嗯、
是
去跟家人一起祷告，然后一祷
告就发命令，
对，就发命令，我说神啊，那个病毒啊全部尿毒素要给我降下来，然后那个肾脏要恢复正常，要有功能啊，然后心脏的问题也是要能够解决。没有想到当天傍晚哦，6点哦，我们就收到消息他转到普通病房哦。对，而且更激励我的是2个礼拜之后他出院了，
而且没事，
对，他现在越来越好了，而且整个是回到一个正常的生活里面。对，真的是遵命发预言，没有想到那个功效是这么的大，而且神真的是要我们去做这个事情。
是
对，
哇，非常吉利。我这两天也是收到 WhatsApp， 我们有一个组长告诉我，他就跟他的门徒说，因为门徒身上有一个瘤，这个瘤呢就在女性的部分，所以他就叫他，你现在就为你的瘤来发预言，宣告求神医治那一些所有的坏细胞，所有的问题要解决，所以他为他自己发预言，他为他自己来宣告，结果就是昨天而已他们就send给我，然后医生就查了之后说，哎，你的瘤不见，所以我觉得哇，这个很真实哦。所以亲爱的弟兄姐妹，我们今天真的在这一个里程里边，我们再一次重讲我们的意向，其实最主要是要建立弟兄姐妹，我们重新让大家看到神托付我们的一份骸骨复活的意向， 让我们可以有信心的去领受，并且我们有信心的去遵命，我们也有信心的去相信，很多不可能的事情是可以有翻转的机会。所以我在这里真的很鼓励我们所有全体 GA 610粮堂的弟兄姐妹们，我们一起领受以西结骸骨复活的意象，并且为你的环境，为你的家人，为你的公司，为你周遭的事情，我们都能够发命令宣告，并且我们的眼光一定要超越许多的问题和困难，让我们一起来经历神迹，经历事情的翻转。就算还没有发生，继续的相信，因为就好像以西结是到了他去世了，然后以色列真正可以恢复。所以我们相信神实在是好神，愿神祝福大家信心提升，骸骨复活，遵命发预言。好，我们今天主任牧师的话就讲到这里，愿神祝福你们，我们一起跟大家说再见。
各位大家平安。
Shalom to everyone.
各位以西结们平安。
Shalom to all Ezekiels.
很开心今天我可以跟 Pastor Lu Zhen 一起来分享神的话语。
Really joyful that today I can share the word of God with Pastor Ruth.
我想问问我们当中谁知道是自己是蒙神拣选的，请举手一下。
So among all of us, if you know you are chosen by God, raise up your hand.
哎，很多哎
，So many of you。
哎，我也是蒙神拣选的。
I'm also the chosen one by God。
我们都是蒙神拣选的。
We are all chosen one by God。
什么叫做蒙神拣选啊
？So what does it mean when you are chosen by God？
原来当神拣选我们的时候，神有一个的心意在我们生命里面。
So when you are being chosen by God, God has a will for you。
所以今天我们要分享一个主题叫做回应神的大蓝图。
So today we are sharing this sermon entitled "Responding to God's Blueprint."
我们过去几个星期我们都在说GA 的意向， GA 的呼召。
The few weeks in past few weeks, we have been sharing about the calling and the vision of GA.
就是要兴起神国大军，影响转化世代，成为生命树教会。
That is to rise up generations, the great army of God to empower and to transform the generations to be tree of life.
这个是我们回应神的拣选啊。
And this is how we respond to God's calling.
但是我们要回应神的拣选的时候，我们必须要知道神的心意是什么。
So as we are responding to God's choosing, we have to know His will.
我们过去一直讲以西结书37:1-10.
So in the past, we have been sharing about Ezekiel chapter 37:10.
但是神的话没有结束。
But that is not the end of God's word.
因为11-14，神仍然在继续对以西结说话。
Because verse 11-14, God continued to spoke to Ezekiel.
所以我们在进入经文之前。
So before we read the scriptures,
我们想要了解一下神对以色列这一个国家这一组犹太人的拣选。
So let us understand the choosing and the will of God towards the Israel and also the Jews.
起初
，in the beginning,
神认识了亚伯拉罕
，knew Abraham.
亚伯拉罕对神很有信心
，and Abraham has full faith in God.
纵使环境周遭都没有一个人相信耶和华神
，even though no one around him believed in Jehovah God.
但是神说耶。亚伯拉罕，你真的是有信心啊
！But God told Abraham that you truly have faith.
所以神拣选亚伯拉罕与亚伯拉罕立约。
And therefore God chose Abraham and had a covenant with him.
在创世纪17:6-8.
In Genesis chapter 17:6-8.
我必使你的后裔极其繁多，国度从你而立，君王从你而出。我要与你并你世世代代的后裔建立我的约，做永远的约，是要做你和你后裔的神。我要将你现在寄居的地。就是迦南全地赐给你和你的后裔永远为业，我也必做他们的神。
神拣选亚伯拉与他立约的时候
，So at the moment when God chose Abraham and had a covenant with him，
亚伯拉不是一个特别显赫的人。
So Abraham wasn't anyone outstanding.
他只是一个普通人。
He was just a commoner.
跟你跟我一样普通人。
Just like you and I, commoner.
但是他相信神。
But he believed in God.
神与他立约。
And God has a covenant with him.
说我会给你一个国啊。
I will give you a kingdom.
国度从你而出，君王从你而出。
And I'll make nations of you, and kings shall come from you.
你的世世代代的后裔都是与我有约的。
And I will establish my covenant between me and you and your descendants.
还有你这所居住的迦南地，我都要赐给你。
And also the land that you are living on the Canaan land, I will give it to you.
神盼望亚伯兰还有他的后裔的国度起来的时候，成为一个的典范。
So God wants Abraham and his descendants as they rise up, they become an example.
一个信心的典范,
an example of faith.
才可以在那个时代,
so that and that generation,
那个时代,
at that era,
成为彰显神的一个的器皿,
becomes that vessel to manifest God.
世世代代也是如此,
and for generations to come, they will do likewise.
所以亚伯兰生了以撒,
so after Abraham begot Isaac,
以撒也生雅各,
Isaac begat Jacob.
雅各过后改名叫做以色列,
and Jacob became Israel.
因为旱灾,
because of a famine.
以色列带着他全家去到了, 埃及,
Israel brought the whole household to go to Egypt.
在埃及400年啊,
for 400 years, 为奴, they stayed as a slave in Egypt.
神没有忘记他们,
but God did not forget them.
神一直记得他与亚伯兰所立的约,
he always remembered the covenant he made with Abraham.
所以神才派摩西带领以色列人出, 出埃及去到迦南地,
so God sent Moses to lead the Israelites to come out into Canaan land.
以色列国成立了起来,
so therefore the forming of the nation of Israel.
他们有王起来,
and they have kings among them.
最著名的大卫王,
and the most famous king, King David.
一个敬畏爱神紧紧跟随神的一个王,
a king that loves and follows God closely.
在执政当中,
so during his reign,
当遇到什么困难, 遇到什么问题, 他首先的是对准神,
whenever he faced challenges, he will face God first.
纵使有软弱,
even though he has setbacks,
但是他没有离弃神,
but he has never abandoned God.
他的儿子所罗门起来做王,
his son King Solomon reigned,
更是带领以色列进到一个更颠, 更, 丰盛的时期,
and led Israel into a much more prosperous generation,
成了那个时代最很强的一个国家,
and become a very powerful nation at that era.
然而,
however,
所罗门的孩子,
the sons of Solomon became king.
他的后裔,
and the descendants,
起来做王的时候,
after they became king,
却不认识神,
they did not know God.
带了许多外邦的偶像进到以色列地,
and they brought a lot of the idols from the foreign land into Israel.
整个国家的属灵光景变得很黑暗,
so the spiritual atmosphere in Israel became very dark.
人不再敬拜敬畏耶和华,
and no one really worshiped Jehovah God anymore.
只是拜在那些的偶像,
and they were worshiping the idols.
没有人记得律例典章,
and nobody remembered the statutes and commandments.
社会道德变得败坏,
and their social morality became deteriorated.
在位的执政权势更是腐败,
and those in power are very corrupted.
做到这样差,
and they are in such a bad state.
神没有忘记,
but God did not forget them.
神仍然爱着以色列,
and God still loves Israel.
透过先知,
and through prophets,
向君王说话,
speaking to the kings,
向百姓说话,
speaking to the people.
但是以色列啊,
and say, Israel,
没有一个人愿意听,
nobody is willing to listen.
他们不听,
they don't want to listen.
他们仍然坚持自己的私欲,
and they are very stubborn with their own lust.
他们不愿意悔改,
and they want to repent.
结果造成北国灭亡,
and therefore the northern kingdom was destroyed.
南国犹大国被掳,
and the southern kingdom was taken into captivity.
被掳是被掳了三次,
when they are taken captive, they were done 3 times.
第一次是在主前605年,
and the first time was 605 BC.
当时候神说, 你们以色列不要反抗当时的强国巴比伦,
and God was telling them, do not resist Babylon at that time.
不要起来背叛他,
do not rebel against them.
但是那时候的王没有听,
but the king did not heed this advice.
结果巴比伦, and,
and therefore Babylon taken captive.
当时候许多贵族和王族,
of all the nobles in the nation.
当时候但以理也在其中,
and among them was Daniel.
过了, 大约有8年之久,
and after 8 years,
以色列又是不听,
Israel refused to listen to the command again.
结果, in the end, 巴比伦又掳掠了他们一大批的人,
Babylon went and taken captive of more people.
约有1万人去到巴比伦,
10,000 of them went to Babylon.
木匠啊, 铁匠啊, 勇士啊, 祭司,
warriors, priests, craftsmen,
许多的专业人士都被掳了,
all these professionals and experts were taken captive.
包括当时候的以西结,
including Ezekiel at that time.
被掳到了巴比伦之地的时候, 是没有盼望, 是绝望的,
when he was in Babylon, he was hopeless.
以前我在我的国家是医生, 是律师, 是工程师, 是专业人士,
in the past I was a doctor, I was a lawyer, I was a professional.
但是被掳到了巴比伦,
but now I'm in Babylon.
我只是洗碗工阿帮阿嘎罢了,
I'm just an Abang Aga who do the dishes.
我是奴隶来的,
I'm a slave.
没有盼望,
I have no hope.
但是,
but
我的国还在啊,
my nation is still
我的神是真的,
there.
我的神是真的,
my God is
有一天他会来拯救我们啊,
true. One day he will come and save us.
10年过后,
after 10 years,
以西结还有中被掳的犹太人听到了一个消息,
Ezekiel and also those in captivity, they heard this news.
第三批的犹太人被掳了,
The third batch of Israelites were being taken captive because they refused to listen to God's order.
背叛 Babylon.
They rise up and rebel against Babylon.
把整个国家在 主前586年所有人都被掳了。
And finally, everyone were being taken captive in 586 BC.
圣经说只有极穷非常贫穷的人留在本地。
The Bible says it's only those who are poorest among the people were left in Israel.
当中还有耶利米在其中。
And that includes Jeremiah.
被掳的人当中真的是没有盼望。
Among those who are taken captive, they have no hope.
我被掳。
I'm being taken captive.
我被灭。
And I was destroyed.
谁来拯救我啊?
Who can come and save us?
就在这样没有盼望的时候,
when they are in such a desolation,
神给以西结看见这个骸骨复活的意象,
God allowed Ezekiel to see this vision of dry bones resurrecting.
看见骸骨能够起来,
when he saw these dry bones coming up,
神的气息进到骸骨里面,
and God's breath entered into these dry bones, become great army.
然后神在11、14节就向以西结解释这一个的意象。
And God explains this vision in verse 11 to 14.
主对我说：“人子啊，这些骸骨就是以色列全家。他们说，我们的骨头枯干了，我们的指望失去了，我们灭绝静静了。所以你要发预言对他们说：主耶和华如此说，我的民啊。” 我必开你们的坟墓，使你们从坟墓中出来，领你们进入以色列地。我的名啊，我开你们的坟墓，使你们从坟墓中出来，你们就知道我是耶和华。我必将我的灵放在你们里面，你们就要活了。我将你们安置在本地，你们就知道我耶和华如此说，也如此成就了。这是耶和华说的。
原来神透过这个骸骨复活成大军的意象。
So God, through this vision of dry bones becoming great army,
对犹太人说,我会向你们做三件事情。
Speaking to the Jews, they say that I will perform three things.
我会打开你们的坟墓,
I will open your graves.
让你们从巴比伦的辖制当中自由,
and cause you to have freedom among the Babylon.
并且你可以出来,
and you can come out
to Babylon. 我要带领你回到以色列地,
and lead you back to the land of Israel.
这是我会做的,
this is what I shall do.
那么你们就知道我是耶和华。
Then you will know that I am Jehovah God.
果然,
and truly,
在主前539年
in 539 BC
距离第一次被掳约70年过后
70 years after the first captivity
一夜之间
just overnight
波斯帝国起来打败了巴比伦
Persian Empire defeated Babylon
然后神借着波斯王塞鲁斯下令叫犹太人得以回归到以色列
So through a decree of the King Cyrus of Persia the Jews were able to return to Israel
可以重建圣殿 重建耶路撒冷
and rebuild the temple and Jerusalem
神说你们就知道我是耶和华
and God says then you will know I am Jehovah God
我开你们的坟墓 领你们出来回到以色列地 你们就知道我是耶和华
I open your graves and lead you back to Israel then you will know that I am Jehovah God
因为人做不了什么
because man shall not be able to do anything
被掳的人他们做不了反抗
Those who are in captivity, they cannot resist.
留在耶路撒冷的人啊，贫穷，没有能力来拯救。
Those who are poor in Israel, they cannot save you.
以色列人什么都没有做。
And the Israelites did nothing.
但是神出手。
But God stretched out his arm.
叫波斯帝国一夜之间打败巴比伦，释放犹太人回到他们的国家。
Allow the Persian Empire to defeat Babylon so that these Jews can return home.
你们就知道我是耶和华。
Then you will know that I'm Jehovah.
弟兄姐妹。
Brothers and sisters.
蒙神拣选的人，我们要知道神是神啊。
We as God's chosen people, we need to know God is God.
因为当我们知道神是神的时候，我们才知道神的在我们生命当中的计划是什么。
Because when we know that God is truly God, then we know His plan.
我们知道神是神的时候，我们才知道神对我生命里面的拣选是什么。
When we regard God as God, then we know His will as of His choosing in us.
当我们不认识神的时候，
when we don't know God,
我们只走自己的路。
We will walk our own way.
我们不认识神的时候，
when we don't know God,
我们不听，
we will not listen.
结果招致的就是被掳。
And then we've been taken captive.
但是神说, 我是耶和华你们的神,
but God says, I'm Jehovah, your God.
我不会忘记与你们有约。
I will not forget my covenant with you.
所以神主导整个历史的发展。
Therefore, God orchestrated the whole history.
让犹太人可以回到自己的本土。
To allow the Jews to go back to their homeland.
因为神纪念。
Because God remember.
但是犹太人回到耶路撒冷，他们有学乖吗？
But did the Jews become better when they returned to homeland?
他们一开始重建圣殿
They rebuild the temple
他们守节期
And they keep the feast days
重读律法书
And read the scrolls again
重建耶路撒冷
And rebuild Jerusalem
但是过不久
But not long after
他们回到当初的那种败坏的时间
They went back to the defilement they did in the past
甚至更恶
and become even more corrupted.
连祭司自己本身,
even the priests themselves,
都藐视耶和华,
despite Jehovah.
这个叫不忠啊,
this is unfaithful.
所以神说我说什么你们会听吗?
So God says, would you listen to anything I say?
神沉默了400年,
and therefore God kept silent for 400 years.
但是400年当中, 过后神差派了他们等候多时的弥赛亚耶稣去到以色列。
But after these 400 years, God sent Messiah, the one that they waited for a long time,
他们帮助他们再次回转归向神,
to help them to turn back to God,
盼望他们不只是有圣殿,
so that they not only have temple,
他们心中更是有敬畏耶和华的那一个的心,
but they have a heart that reveres towards God,
真正明白神心意的那一颗心,
and the heart that truly understands God's will.
但是犹太人却因为自己的传统的思维,
but the Jews, because of their traditional mindset,
有许多律法的主义,
a lot of the mindset of laws,
心里的刚硬,
and the stubbornness in their heart,
他们拒绝承认耶稣就是他们等候的弥赛亚。
They refuse to acknowledge that Jesus is the Messiah they have been waiting for.
把耶稣钉死在十字架上。
And they nailed Jesus on the cross.
尽管耶稣死而复活。
Even though Jesus resurrected from death.
许多人都看见。
A lot of people witnessed that.
他们仍然不信。
They still refuse to believe.
他们仍然在自己的私欲上继续地败坏下去。
They continue to corrupt in their own lust.
他们不服于神的管教。
They are not willing to obey to God's discipline.
最后。
And finally.
70年,
in 70 AD,
耶路撒冷圣殿被毁,
the temple in Jerusalem was destroyed.
他们努力地要维护自己的家园,
and they want to defend their homeland.
但是三年过后,
but 3 years later,
他们最后的基地, 马萨达失守,
the last base camp in Masada was destroyed.
犹太人彻底失去了国家和家园,
so the Jews totally lost their own homeland and nation.
对比当时候, 以西结年代被掳的时期来说,
comparatively with the era of Ezekiel when they were being taken captive,
这一次更加是灭绝尽尽,
this time they were completely destroyed.
更贴切于在以西结书37章里面的意象,
it was more closely related with the vision in chapter 37 in Ezekiel.
那一年以色列这一个字从此在地球上消失,
because that year, the name Israel was wiped off from the face of the earth.
犹太人四处漂泊,
the Jews were scattered and in diaspora.
没有安居之所,
they don't have their own homeland.
他们漂流各地几千年,
they are in diaspora for thousands of years.
你知道在马来西亚,
in Malaysia,
我们还可以听到有人说,
we can hear people say,
你不喜欢你就回中国,
if you don't like, then you go back to China.
你不喜欢你回印度,
or you go back to India.
但是对犹太人来说,
but for the Jews,
没有人可以说, 你不喜欢你回你的国家,
if you don't like it, then you just return to your homeland.
因为犹太人没有国家可以回啊,
because they don't have their own homeland to return to.
千年以来, 他们都是寄居,
for thousands of years, they have been in diaspora.
千年以来, 他们都是看人脸色做人,
and they have to obey other people.
甚至来到16世纪,
even it comes to the 16th century,
在欧洲掀起一股反犹太的主义,
in Europe, there's this anti-Semitism.
每个人觉得犹太人是坏的,
everybody thinks that the Jews are very corrupted.
所以他们开始歧视犹太人,
and therefore they start to despise these Jews,
辖制犹太人,
and to restrict them.
事情研发一直带来到1941年到45年,
and over time until 1945,
发生了一 我们都知道的纳粹的大屠杀事件,
then this is Nazi caused this Holocaust.
许多的在, 特别是在欧洲居住的犹太人都被屠杀,
a lot of these Jews staying in Europe, they were being killed.
600,000的普通百姓被屠杀,
6 million of these commoners Jews were being killed.
其中有150万是无辜的儿童,
and more than 1.5 million of them are children who are innocent.
这个时候犹太人在四处漂泊, 他们觉得不行了,
and once again the Jews feel that this cannot go on.
他们仍然记得神曾经所说的预言,
they still remember this prophecy said by God.
他们仍然突然想起神曾经给他们的应许还有所立的约,
they remember the promises that God has for them.
他们想要回到自己的土地,
they want to return to their homeland.
他们开始了争取回到自己土地的一个的运动,
and they start this movement to go back to their homeland.
西安运动,
that is Zionism.
他们努力争取之下,
and under their efforts,
更重要是神的恩典,
most importantly is God's grace,
神的信实,
God's faithfulness.
以色列在1948年迎来复国的那一天,
Israel was being restored as a nation in 1948.
一个灭了的国家在1000多年的历史过后, 终于可以复国。
A nation is destroyed, and then almost 2,000 years later, they were being restored.
这是神在做的事情啊。
This is what God has done.
所以有人说,
so some people say,
在1948年, 以色列的复国,
the restoration of Israel in
1948
is a manifestation of this vision of Ezekiel.
他们终于有了这个国家。
And finally, they have their own nation.
所以这76年以来,
so for these last 76 years,
以色列不断地壮大,
Israel continues to grow stronger.
他们有很强的国防,
and they have very strong military.
有很强大的武器,
very good weapons.
很伟善的军队,
and very faithful soldiers.
以西结第一个预言的结果发生了,
and the first prophecy of Ezekiel has revealed.
有军队起来了,
there's a great army rising up.
但是弟兄姐妹,
but brothers and sisters,
我们想问一个问题,
we want to ask this question.
那以色列有回应到神的心意里面吗?
Did Israel return to the will of God?
有应验了以西结的预言吗?
Did he show up this prophecy of Israel, Ezekiel?
还没有。
No.
因为以色列外表上是很壮大。
Because on the surface, Israel seems strong.
但是内心当中，他们仍然拒绝耶稣这位弥赛亚。
But inside of them, they still reject Jesus as a Messiah.
他们仍然拒绝耶稣是他们的救主。
They still reject Jesus as their savior.
他们外在很壮大,
on their outward appearance, they seem strong.
但是心中灵里却是匮乏的,
but in their heart, their spirit is poor.
很多的犹太人不能够接受,
a lot of Jews, they cannot accept this.
他们没有真正回应到神的大蓝图里面,
they did not go back to God's grand blueprint.
弟兄姐妹,
brothers and sisters,
当我们看这些历史的时候,
as we look at this history,
我们会看到以色列人, 纵使一开始与神有约,
even though the Israelites were with God in the first place,
他们的生命是一时高一时低一时高一时低,
but their life keep fluctuating, ups and downs.
先知说话他们不听,
when the prophet speaks, they don't listen.
神说话他们不听,
when God speaks, they don't listen.
耶稣来他们不信,
and when Jesus came, they did not believe in him.
他们只有外在的知识和能力,
they only have the ability and the knowledge on our appearance.
弟兄姐妹,
brothers and sisters,
其实我们是否像以色列一样呢?
Are we just like the Israelites?
我们知道,
we know.
我们好像有很多的装备,很多的学习,很多的能力,很多的恩赐。
We learn a lot, we have talents, and we have giftings.
但是我们是否有回应到神的呼召,神给我们的意象里面呢?
But do we respond to God's calling and His blueprint?
我们是否有进到神的大蓝图里面呢?
Do we enter into God's grand blueprint?
到底我们缺乏什么?
What are we lacking?
我们都是蒙神拣选的。
We are chosen by God.
为什么我们好像似乎很多东西我们都做不成呢?
But it seems like we cannot accomplish a lot of things.
为什么我传福音家人还是没有信主呢?
And I evangelize and my family haven't come to Christ.
去到我职场里面做改变祷告仍然没有翻转呢?
And I go to marketplace and pray and there's no transformation.
为什么神呼召给我的意向我清清楚楚但是我回应却没有果效呢?
And when God gave me clear visions but there's no results.
到底我们还缺了什么?
So what are we lacking of?
到底以色列这个复国了缺了什么?
So this nation Israel, when they restore, what are they lacking still?
神在跟我们说,
and God told us,
我所拣选的没有选错,
whatever I chose, I will not make a mistake.
只是在整个意象里面,
but in this vision,
在这个复国里面,
in this restoration of the nation,
这个回应大蓝图里面,
as they respond to this grand blueprint,
有一个很重要的关键,
there's a very important critical point.
是以色列需要, 是我们每一个蒙神拣选的人需要的。
Israel needs it, and every one of us who are chosen, we need it.
那是什么呢?
What is that?
跟你左右隔壁的说,
tell the person next to you,
听清楚。
I'm very,
跟你左右隔壁的说,
tell the person next to you,
听清楚。
Listen properly.
我把时间交给 Pastor Ruth 来讲清楚。
I'll pass the time to Pastor Ruth to share with you clearly.
谢谢 Pastor Moses.
Thank you, Pastor Moses.
是我们要听清楚。
Yes, we shall listen carefully.
这个听清楚要听到什么呢?
Listen carefully. What shall we listen of?
就是他们缺乏的其实就是少了圣灵的工作。
What is lacking in them is the work of the Holy Spirit.
少了圣灵充满在他们里面。
The lack of outpouring of Holy Spirit in them.
虽然以色列复国了,
even though Israel has been restored,
他们也有很强的军事国防能力。
They have great army and defense.
这是世人都一直在追求的东西。
This is what the world is chasing after.
但是神对以色列人的心意不是只是要他们这样子,
but God's will towards the Israel is not to this only,
而是要以色列人起来成为神国的大军,
but God wants them to rise up to become the great army of God's kingdom.
所以就需要有神的灵来充满他们,
hence they need the spirit of the Lord to fill them.
所以14节这里这样说,
therefore in verse 14 it says,
我必将我的灵放在你们里面，你们就要活了。 我将你们安置在本地，你们就知道我耶和华如此说，也如此成就了。这是耶和华说的。神说他必将把他的灵放在以色列人里面。The
Lord says He shall pour His Spirit in the Israelite.
这是一个应许。
This is a promise.
放呢，在这里是一个完成式。To
put is a perfect tense here.
就是说一定会完成的。It
means it shall come to pass.
当灵放在人的里面，以色列人里面。
When the Spirit of the Lord fill the Israelite, they shall come alive.
神要他眼中的军队是活的。
God wants the army in His eyes to be alive.
这个火是有复活的意思。
It means resurrected.
我们知道过去以色列人的光景就是在枯骨里面。
We know that they were in a situation like dry bones in the past.
而要枯骨要能够复活，就需要救赎的工作。
Where the dry bones to come alive, they need the power of resurrection.
救赎就需要透过承认耶稣基督是他们的弥赛亚，他们就可以活过来。It
means salvation that also means to accept Jesus as their Messiah to come alive.
对神来说，人活过来是重要的。For
God, to come alive is very important.
以色列人活过来是重要的。It
is important for the Israelites to come alive.
弟兄姐妹，你活过来是重要的。Brothers
and sisters, for you to come alive, it is likewise important.
因为人没有真正的活过来。If
we have not come alive,
是不能够真正知道耶和华是谁。We
could not truly know who Jehovah is.
也就不能够享福。And
we can't enjoy our lives.
我们要明白，使人复活的只有独一的真神可以做这样子的事情。We
need to know that only the one true God can bring people alive.
唯有神使死的变活。Only
God can make the dead alive.
使无的变有。And
change nothing to something.
这是世上其他神没有任何一个人可以做到的事情。This
is something no other God or anyone can do.
而人会活在死亡里面。
And men will live in death
是因为我们里面有许多的肉体私欲,
because we have a lot of fleshly lust,
有许多的罪,
a lot of sin,
有骄傲,
a lot of pride,
如同以色列人过去的历史一样,
like the history of the Israelites in the past,
他们的不忠,
their unfaithfulness,
不听,
their disobedience,
不愿意顺服,
the unwillingness to obey.
甚至更严肃的是, 他们根本不认识神。
Or more seriously, they do not know God.
所以这些种种的原因就使人在一个的枯骨里面,
all of these factors leave us to be in dry bones and in death.
我们可能也是这样子。
Perhaps we are like these two.
这样子的死亡光景如何可以成为神国的军队呢?
How can we become army of God if we in such a situation.
所以以色列人非常需要主耶稣的救恩。
Therefore, the Israelites truly need the salvation of Jesus Christ.
所以神说他要把他的灵放在人里面，他就活了。
Therefore, Jesus said He shall pour His Spirit in man and He shall come alive.
所以神第一个层面要让我们活过来的是呢?
Therefore, when God wants to keep us alive,
我们大家都做了。
All of us has done this.
就是相信耶稣基督。
To trust in Jesus Christ.
成为我们生命的救主,
to become the savior of our lives.
以色列人也是要这样子。
Likewise to the Israelites.
但是他们真的有太多传统的包袱框架。
But truly they have a lot of traditional mindset.
所以就算耶稣那时候来到他们面前, 他们也都认不出他是弥赛亚。
Even though Jesus has come in their midst in the past, they couldn't recognize him as the Messiah.
所以他们需要圣灵在他们里面。
Therefore, they need the Holy Spirit to be in them.
把他们眼中的被蒙蔽,
to take away
很多生命的这个的传统的东西,
a lot of the traditional mindset in them.
要拿掉,
to take away.
他们要深深知道, 他们需要接受耶稣基督。
They need to truly know that they need to accept Christ.
那他们就能够进到大军的一个的呼召当中。
Then they can enter into the calling of the great army.
神要我们的复活不是只是第一步的接受耶稣而已。
God doesn't want us to stay in the first stage, that is salvation.
透过圣灵的工作，更是要让我们的生命被重建。
Through the work of the Holy Spirit, God wants our lives to be restored.
过去的伤害啊。
The hurts in the past.
生命可能有许多的软弱。
A lot of weaknesses in our lives.
有瘾癖。
Or some addiction.
有性的瘾癖。
Or sexual addiction.
有很多的瘾癖。
A lot of other addictions.
很多的问题。
A lot of problems.
神也要透过他的灵来重建我们这个部分。
Through the power of the Holy Spirit, God wants to restore our lives.
所以活过来是包含我们的生命是要被重建的。
To come alive means our life should come alive and restored.
这些残累我们的拉我们的全部都要在我们生命里面透过圣灵的作为被解决。
All of the baggages that drag us down shall be healed through the power of the Holy Spirit.
进而到神要我们的活过来的一个样子。
To enter into the appearance that God wants them to live in.
就是弟兄姐妹，我们要被复兴。
Brothers and sisters, we shall be revived.
我们要被更新。
We shall be renewed.
我们要有能力。
We need to have power.
以至于当我们经历了这个复活的过程。
So that we can come through this power of resurrection.
我们真的可以明白。
That we can truly understand.
而且口里承认。
And we can admit and confess.
心里是扎实的相信。
And we truly believe in our heart.
知道。
That.
耶和华。
Yehovah.
你就是我的神。
You are my Savior and God.
耶和华。
Yehovah.
就是以色列的神。
Is the God of Israel.
主啊我只能够敬拜你。
God I can only worship you.
主啊我这一生只能够降服于你。
God I will only submit to you in my whole life.
成为你的子民。
To become your children.
好让神你把我安置在神你给亚伯拉罕的那个应许之地。
So that God, you may place me in the promised land that you have given to Abraham.
神也把我们每个人安置在属于我们的地方。
So that God will place us in the place that belongs to us.
去治理。
To manage.
活出神的大蓝图里面我们的那一个部分。
To live in the grand blueprint that God has prepared for each and every one of us.
以色列人就能在地上代表神来治理跟管理。
So that the Israel can represent God to administer in the earth.
所以当神每次对他们发命令要他们去做的时候
So every time when God commanded them
他们就能够有能力去执行
They will have the power to do
所以在使徒行传二章十七十八节这里这样说
Therefore in the book of Acts chapter 2 verse 17 to 18
神说在末后的日子我要将我的灵浇灌凡有血气的你们的儿女要说预言你们的少年人要见异象老年人要做异梦在那些日子我要将我的灵浇灌我的仆人和使女他们就要说预言。
所以这一群的属灵大军呢
So this great team of a spiritual great army
如同这里经文讲的是被圣灵大大浇灌的
If they have the outpouring of the Holy Spirit
这个军队当中的无论男女老少
Irrespective of male, female, young or old in this group
都是被浇灌的
They have been filled by the Holy Spirit.
都有圣灵的大能。
They have the power of the Holy Spirit.
他们看得到神的心意。
They can see the heart of God.
看到神的心意之后就透过他们的口去宣告出来去发预言。
After knowing the will of God, they are able to prophesy.
能够对这世代说话。
And speak to this nation.
弟兄姐妹我们在这里的男女老少。
Brothers and sisters, male, female, young and old of us here.
圣灵都要大大的来充满我们。
The Holy Spirit shall greatly fill us.
神不只是要坐在以色列人身上。
Not only that God wants to work in the Israelites.
更是要坐在我们身上。
More importantly, he wants to work in us.
这些都一定会发生的。
All of this shall come to pass.
以色列大军他要兴起来之前呢
Before the great army of the Israelites shall come alive
神一定要兴起外邦人
God shall rise up the Gentiles first
也就是在这里的每一个人
That is each and every one of us here
我们都是外邦人
We are all Gentiles
因为在罗马书十一章二十五节 这里这样说
Because it is stated in the book of Romans chapter 11 verse 25
神要等到外邦人得救的人数填满了
God wants to wait until the fullness of the Gentiles has come in.
而后呢 这样子以色列全家就要得救。
Then the entire Israel shall be saved.
而在那时刻，以西结的预言就可以成就。
And at that time, the prophecy of Ezekiel shall come to pass.
我们期盼这一天能够早一点的到来。
We truly hope that these prophecies shall come to pass quickly.
所以身为外邦人的我们，
So we as Gentiles,
我们需要被圣灵大浇灌。
We need the outpouring of the Holy Spirit.
我们需要被兴起来成为大军。
We need to be revived to be great army.
我们要有信心看到。 有一天复兴也要来到我们这一代。
We have to see that great revival shall come to us in faith.
复兴要临到其中一个很重要我们要做的。
One important thing that we shall do for revival to come,
我们要对这个世代发预言。
Is that to prophesy to this generation.
告诉我们周围还有许多未得之民。
To speak to the lost soul surrounding us,
使他们也领受耶稣基督的救赎。
So that they can likewise receive the salvation of Jesus Christ.
这样子当外邦人得救的人数满足了，
So that when the fullness of the Gentiles has come in,
应许就要应验。
The promise shall come to pass.
所以弟兄姐妹，是时刻我们要起来动。
Brothers and sisters, it is time for us to act now.
我们要透过圣灵大能浇灌我们。
Through the outpouring of the Holy Spirit,
我们要在神放我们的地方。
We shall place ourselves in the place that God wants to place us in.
无论是我们的家庭，
Whether in our family,
学校，
Schools,
职场，
Marketplace,
国家，
Nation,
等等的地方，
etc.
我们要发预言。
We shall prophesy.
我们要领人得救。
We want to lead people to salvation.
也相信以色列人。
And believe that for the Israelites,
会有蒙救赎的那一天。
There will be day for them to receive the salvation.
所以我们要很渴望 圣灵再来帮助我们。
We shall desire of the visitation of the Holy Spirit.
使我们枯干的地方活过来。
So that wherever there is dry bone, there shall come alive.
我很感恩神这次回台湾。
I'm truly grateful to God for bringing back to Taiwan.
能够有能力去为人家祷告。
That I have the ability to pray for others.
其实除了这件事之外呢，
Apart from this incident,
还有一件事情发生。
There is also another thing that had happened.
就是我刚到台湾那一天，
The day when I just touched Taiwan,
我哥哥从机场接我们回家。
My brother received us from the airport.
在路上就听到，
In the journey, I was informed,
我的一个家人，
One of my family members,
原来在去年七八月的时候，
In July or August last year,
医生确定他得了乳癌第二期。
Doctor diagnosed that she is having second stage cancer, breast cancer.
哇，我的心掉到谷底。
I was so upset.
因为我那一天回到家是吃年夜饭的一天。
Because the day of arrival is the Chinese New Year Eve.
但是听到这个很难过。
But I was so saddened by this news.
心中有个大石头在那里。
There is a great burden in my heart.
但是这段期间我也依旧连线着我们教会的 信息，我也是在听。
But I continue to be connected with our services.
那我从我家人那里得知说，他二月底还要再做一次的检查，看状况怎样。
And I also got to know that in February, his cousin will go and visit doctor again.
所以我听信息，
I listened to the messages.
然后我也凭信心，
And by faith,
我就不断祷告。
I continue to pray.
一直祷告。
Continue to pray.
我说神，
And I say God,
你一定要实行神迹奇事。
You shall perform your miracles.
我要我家人的疾病， 这个是好的。
I want my family members to be healed from the sicknesses.
感恩神。
Thanks be to God.
在过去的前的几天，
But for the past few days,
我得知，
I was informed,
我这个家人去做切片检查。
I was made to understand that this family member went for a checkup.
没有癌细胞。
And the biopsy diagnosed that there is no cancer cell.
接下来还要做更全面的 一个的检查。
And she needs to do a complete checkup later on.
我继续用信心来宣告。
I continue to declare by faith.
是完全的没有。
That completely,
而且要从医生的口中宣告出来，没有这个疾病了。
There shall be this report by the doctor that she is completely healed.
弟兄姐妹，我们周围可能我们的家人，
Brothers and sisters in our surrounding, like our families, our friends,
我相信有很多这样子的需要。
I believe there are a lot of needs.
还有很多没有得救。
A lot of lost souls.
看不到盼望。
They do not see hope.
但是现在是时刻起来动了。
But it is now the time to act.
因为神的大蓝图里面，
Because in the great blueprint of God,
GA也是
要去拿我们的那一份。
GA shall also claim our portion.
就是军队。
That is great army.
把预言的军队。
A great army that prophesies.
是时刻我们动起来，在对我们的所有我们周围要发预言了。
For us to act and prophesy to our surrounding.
那我们要神再来帮我们。
And we want God to come and help us again.
我们要圣灵极大的能力来充满我们。
We want the great power of the Holy Spirit to fill us.
今天我们就要求圣灵来帮我们。
Today, let us ask of the help of the Holy Spirit.
我想邀请大家站起来。
I would like to welcome everyone to stand.
神的大蓝图。
The great blueprint of God.
我们每个人都在其中是一份。
We are a part of it.
但是今天为什么我们还不可以呢？
Today, why are we still unable?
其实是我们生命当中还有很多软弱没有被除去。
Because there are still a lot of weaknesses in our lives that we have not dealt with.
我们对神的不信。
The unbelief in us.
我们不知道他是耶和华。
We didn't know that he is Jehovah.
我们不是真认识他。
We did not truly know him.
我们里面还有怀疑。
There is doubt in us.
所以我们没办法。
Therefore,
在这个大蓝图里面往前走。
We are unable to march forward in this great blueprint.
那弟兄姐妹，
brothers and sisters,
我想邀请大家，
I would like to invite everyone,
闭上眼睛，
to close your eyes.
我相信圣灵现在要来对我们说话。
I believe the Holy Spirit wants to speak to you now.
什么是我们的软弱呢？
What are our weaknesses?
是不是我们还有许多的伤害在我们里面？
Could that be the past hurts?
我们一直困在这当中。
We continue to struggle in it.
它一直把我们往下拉。
It keep dragging us down.
还是我们有在我们的隐蔽罪恶里面。
Or in our addiction or our sins.
我们依旧出不来。
We are able to come out of it.
可能今天。
Perhaps today.
我们都还不真实知道他是耶和华。
We do not truly know that He is Jehovah.
求圣灵帮我们。
May the Holy Spirit help us.
求圣灵帮我们。
May Holy Spirit help us.
我们先用这首歌来回应神。
Let us respond to God through this song.
Who can tell us who we are when there's no faith in us? Where can I put my trust when there seems to be no hope?There is only one God who is always by my side. By His words He restores me and leads me all the way. And say what He says. So come prophesy to these dry bones. So come prophesy.
I felt that the Holy Spirit wants to heal us.
弟兄姐妹，我们真的要求圣灵开我们的眼睛。
Brothers and sisters, let us ask of the Holy Spirit to open our eyes.
我们要先看到。
We need to first see.
使我们复活。
That let us be
capitalized. 使我们得救。
That we shall be saved.
使我们从伤害里面。
That we can come out from our hurt.
罪恶里面。
From our sin.
出来的这一位神。
The only true God that can lead us out from all of this. is.
是永活独一的真神,
the only true living God.
所以我们的伤害,
so that all our hurts,
我们的罪恶,
our sins,
可以透过他圣灵的大能,
and through the power of the Holy Spirit,
是可以被医治的,
can be healed,
是可以被释放的,
can be released.
弟兄姐妹,
brothers and sisters,
我要你带着这样子的信心,
I want you to bring along such faith,
来领受,
to receive,
领受,
and receive,
领受,
receive,
领受,
receive,
领受,
receive,
圣灵对你的医治,
the healing by the Holy Spirit,
圣灵现在对你的医治,
the healing by the Holy Spirit,
医治,
now, healing,
医治,
healing.
我奉耶稣基督的名宣告,
in Jesus' name I declare,
我们当中有一个的消极的氛围,
there is this very negative atmosphere in us,
有一个很深的压制,
there is a deep oppression,
神现在要来医治你,
God wants to heal you now.
我奉耶稣基督的名宣告,
in Jesus' name I declare,
现在医治要进入我们灵里的地方,
now healing shall come into our spirit now.
现在,
right now,
所有被压制的地方,
all that has been oppressed,
我奉耶稣基督的名宣告,
in Jesus' name I declare,
要断开锁链,
to break all the chains,
断开锁链,
break the chains,
一切的消极,
all the oppression,
我奉耶稣基督的名宣告,
and depression I declare, in Jesus' name,
要破除这个消极,
I break all of this depression,
离开我们的弟兄姐妹,
to leave our brothers and sisters,
还有我看到,
and I see,
我们当中弟兄姐妹,
brothers and sisters in our midst,
你在一个瘾癖里面,
you are having certain addiction,
你知道这个瘾癖困扰你很久了,
and you know that this addiction has troubled you for a very long time,
神今天要来释放你,
God wants to release you,
而且神要告诉你,
and God is saying,
祂不是要来控告你,
he is not condemning you,
祂把这个事情显明出来,
he revealed this thing,
不是要控告你,
not to condemn you,
是要释放你从这个瘾癖里面完全的得自由,
but to completely release you from this addiction,
反而是要让你,
so that
不再继续被仇敌来控告,
you will no longer be condemned by the enemy,
因为神说祂看到你被控告到非常的辛苦,
because God sees your struggle as you are binded,
你常常头低低的,
you always look down,
你不敢面对人,
you are unable to face others,
你活在人面前是一个假象的你,
it is, you are hiding yourself,
但是今天,
but today,
我奉耶稣基督的名宣告,
in Jesus' name I declare,
这个隐蔽带来的羞耻感,
all the shamefulness brought by this addiction,
仇敌对你的控告,
all the condemnation from the enemy,
现在,
right now,
断开锁链,
the chain shall be broken,
这个隐蔽,
this addiction,
我奉耶稣基督的名宣告,
in Jesus' name I declare,
离开,
live,
离开,
live,
离开,
live,
离开,
live,
羞耻感从你的灵里面完全的离开,
shamefulness shall leave your spirit,
你不再是一个羞耻的人,
you no longer live in shame,
罪恶不能再捆锁你,
the guilt and shame can no longer bind you,
有弟兄姐妹,
also in our
你常常觉得自己不能,
you always feel that you are ashamed,
你都看不起你自己,
you despise yourself,
因为你觉得你是没有能力的人,
because you feel that you are unable,
你在你的工作上面, 你也觉得你做得很糟糕,
you feel that you do very lousy at your work,
你也管理得很糟糕,
you are unable to manage your family matters,
我奉耶稣基督的名宣告,
in Jesus' name I declare,
这个思想上面的坚固营垒,
all these strongholds in your thoughts,
圣灵你的大能,
the power of the Holy Spirit,
拆毁这个坚固营垒,
to break this stronghold,
回到耶稣的脚前去,
to cast them into the legs of Jesus Christ,
回到耶稣的脚前去,
to retreat to the feet of Jesus,
弟兄姐妹,
brothers and sisters,
领受,
receive,
耶稣说,
Jesus said,
圣灵说,
and the Holy Spirit said,
巨业的大军,
great army of Jew,
起来,
rise up,
起来,
rise up,
我们能够的,
we are able,
因为圣灵的能力,
because of the power of the Holy Spirit,
现在,
right now,
在我们里面,
is in us,
起来,
rise up,
起来,
rise up,
巨业的男女老少,
great army of Jew,
起来,
rise up,
起来,
rise up,
hallelujah,
hallelujah.
是的,
yes.
你知道在大屠杀之前有一个人物,
do you know that there's this person before the Holocaust happened?
在1896年 叫做西奥多赫茨尔,
in 1896 his name is Theodor Herz.
他是生在匈牙利,
and he was born in Hungary,
在一个犹太人,
in, as a, he's a Jew.
当时他写了一个小册子,
and that time he wrote a pamphlet.
他说犹太人在世界各地被排挤。
He says the Jews were being discriminated all over the world.
所以他的小册子写犹太国。
So the title of this template is the Jewsat.
等于说他要让犹太人可以立国。
That is to encourage the forming of Jewish state.
他说犹太人的问题。
He says the problem of the Jews
不是社会。
Is not a society problem.
不是宗教的问题。
Is not a religious problem.
而是他们民族里面的问题。
But it's a tribal problem.
所以他说只有回到自己国家
Only when they return to their own homeland
所以从他1896年到1948年总共52年的日子
So from 1896 to 1948 in 52 years
所以52年的日子很不容易过
So they have a difficult time in these 52 years
因为在他们要立国前几年就是1941到1945年以色列人犹太人在德国被大屠杀600万人死。
Because in 1941 to 1945, the Jews were experienced Holocaust in Germany.
所以我们看到神的大蓝图。
So we see this grand blueprint of God.
以西结的预言要成就。
The prophecy of Ezekiel shall turn to pass.
但是仇敌一直在拖延。
But the enemy is delaying the plan.
仇敌一直在拦阻。
And is hindering the plan.
甚至在杀害。
And even to kill.
今天在我们的末后这个时代
So in the last days today,
你要怎么样进入大蓝图
How can you enter into this blueprint?
你的人生的蓝图怎么样跟大蓝图一起完成呢
How can your life work together with this grand blueprint?
亲爱的弟兄姐妹在你每一天的抉择真的很重要
Brothers and sisters, as you do your decision every day is very important.
你相信神对你的呼召吗
Are you clear of God's calling to you?
你相信神在你的人生里面的这一段原来是要成就大蓝图吗
Do you believe that God has a plan for you to accomplish this grand blueprint?
但是谁会拦阻你呢
But who will hinder you?
所以仇敌四面拦阻
Devil will stop you from all ways.
四面给你谎言
In all ways deceive you.
四面在让你失望
And to cause disappointment in you.
所以我们为什么要像以西结
So why should we be like Ezekiel?
因为我们要看到大蓝图
Because we have to see the blueprint.
我们才看到我们的生命如何拦阻神的工作
Then only we can see how our lives hinder God's work.
我们的不信
Our disbelief.
我们的消极
Our pessimism.
我们的软弱
Our setbacks.
甚至我们给仇敌留地步
We leave a foothold for the enemy.
所以让整个蓝图一直被拖延，被拖延。
Causing delay to this grand blueprint.
但是到最后
But at the end time,
你说神的心意会成就吗
Can God's heart be accomplished?
每一句话都不落空
Each single word will not go in vain.
所以神的心意一定成就。
So God's heart shall surely be accomplished.
可是你在哪里呢
But where are you?
你在这个大蓝图的哪一个角落呢
Which corner are you at in this grand blueprint?
所以神用各种方法眺望我们，帮我们。
So God used all ways to stir and help us.
就是要我们度过我们每一个的关卡，每一个的难关。
So that we can prevail all kind of challenges.
因为他愿意你在大蓝图里面，你完成你的部分。
Because He wants you to accomplish your part in this blueprint.
无论你是一个组长
，whether you are a cell leader，
无论你是一个传道人
，or a pastor，
无论你是一个弟兄姐妹在职场里面每一个角落工作的弟兄姐妹
，or brothers and sisters who works in different corner of the marketplace，
神拣选你那一刻，当你成为基督徒那一天，他对你就有一个计划。
So when you became Christian, that God has a will for you.
这个计划
，and this will，
只有你可以成就。
Only you can accomplish
你自己的那一个部分
the part that belongs to you.
而在整个大蓝图里面，你是一个 puzzle.
And in this grand blueprint, you are that piece of puzzle.
在神的心中
in God's heart,
愿意每一个人都能够活出他的命定
He wants everyone to live out their destiny.
每一个人都在大蓝图里有一份
And everyone has this portion in this blueprint.
主啊，求你的灵领导我们
Lord, may your spirit come upon us.
挑望我们所有认识你的基督徒们
And stir us up, Christian who knows you.
让他们的眼睛、他们的耳朵、他们的思维不被捆绑
So that their eyes, their ears, their mindset will not be bound.
他们得医治
They'll be healed.
跟你同行
And march with you.
直到见你的面
Until we see you.
主求你恩待这里每一个人
Lord, may you be gracious to everyone.
因为神爱我们
Because God loves us.
神爱你
God loves you.
神愿你在这一个大蓝图，你能走得进去。
So God wants you to enter into this blueprint.
今天神在以色列继续工作的。
God continue to work in Israel today.
虽然他们在战争，
even though they are in a war.
虽然四面楚歌，
even though they are facing threats.
但是神没有离开过任何一个人。
But God has not departed any single person.
亲爱弟兄姐妹，
dear brothers and sisters,
我们领受神的灵。
Let us receive the Spirit of God.
挑旺我们的心。
And stir our hearts up.
打开我们的眼睛。
Open up our eyes.
打开我们的生命。
Open up our lives.
得医治。
To receive healing.
为了往前行。
So that we can advance forward.
为了完成神托付的。
To accomplish what God has for us.
为了你的家。
For your family.
为了你的下一代。
For your next generation.
我们继续用这首歌来结束。
Let's continue to sing this song.
So come prophesy to the tribals. So come prophesy to the brave from the four winds. The Spirit of God is moving. The Spirit of God is breathing into those who are slain. So arise from the dust of the ground. So
You want to save us.
你愿意医治我们。
And you want to heal us.
你愿意释放我们。
And you are willing to deliver us.
让我们进到我们的命定。
So that you can enter into our destiny.
在大蓝图里面。
In this grand blueprint.
我们能够成为其中的一份子。
We can become a part of it.
谢谢你祷告奉耶稣的名。
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
在我们